Hello everyone, welcome to the third session of science. We were discussing about microorganisms and we have discussed about bacteria. Today we are going to discuss about fungi. Fungi again is a plural, singular of fungi is fungus. These are the thread like structure, plant like, they look like plant, and they are, most of them are multicellular, but they are non-green, means they are not having chlorophyll in them, that's why they are not autotrophs also. They cannot prepare their own food. The study of fungi is having a special branch that is known as mycology. It is the branch of science in which we study about the fungi. All the fungi I told you are multicellular, most of them. Only one unicellular example is there among fungi, that is of yeast. Yeast are unicellular. They are having only one cell, but these cells are remain attached with each other, that we will discuss in the process of reproduction. So this is the structure of yeast, that is unicellular. Rest of the fungi are multicellular. And the most common fungi that you are familiar with is the mushroom. You all know the structure of this type of umbrella like structure it is having with a stalk. This is the fungi. Another example is bread mold, rhizopus, that grow on the rotten food or the especially on the bread and pickles. That is also a fungi. The mode of nutrition, because they are non-green, not having chlorophyll, that's why the mode of nutrition is either saprophyte or parasite. Saprophyte means, again I am telling you, those living organisms that take their food from dead and decaying matter, they are known as saprophyte. So fungi are either saprophytic in nature or parasitic. Parasitic take their food from the body of another living organism, that is known as host. So if they are living on the body of the another living organism, they are disease causing, and they causes disease in plant as well as in animals also. Fungal diseases, you are familiar with. Now coming to the mode of reproduction, there are two ways of reproduction. Mainly they reproduce asexually, by either spore formation or by budding. As I told you, yeast is an unicellular organism, and an outgrowth arises from the body of the yeast. That outgrowth is known as a bud. That bud grows in size and attain maximum size. It may detach itself from the body of the parent, or it may remain attached to the body of the parent also and forming a chain like structure. But this process of reproduction is known as budding. Spore formation takes place in rhizopus or mushrooms also. What happens? The main structure of rhizopus or bread mold is having, I told you, is thread like structure. These thread like structures are known as hyphae, are plural, or hypha is singular. One of the hyphae, it become erect, and the end of the hyphae, this hypha swells to form a bag-like or sac-like structure that is known as sporangium. Inside this sporangium, small spores are produced. They remain in the sporangium, and whenever the conditions are favorable, they mature. This sporangium bursts and all the spores spread into air and water. So they germinate, they spread, dispersal takes place through air. So this is the mode of reproduction in fungi. Now we are coming to the another group, that is known as algae. Algae is again plural and the singular is alga. They are also known as grass of water. The slippery layer you can find out near the on the surface of the pond, river, lake, inside the ocean also, even on the moist rock or soil, a slippery green layer is present. These are the algae only. They may be unicellular, having one cell like Chlamydomonas, or they may be multicellular or filamentous. Filament, like this type of filament, thread like structure they are again made up of, and this filament may be branched or unbranched. take the example of a Spirogyra. It is not having branch filament, only single unbranched filament is there. But in the case of Polyscyphonia fucus, these are the branch filaments. But if the body is multicellular, it is filamentous also. Now coming to the habitat, I told you they are aquatic, they live in water or on moist surfaces like moist soil, yeah, or rock, moist, where moisture is present, they can easily grow and form a slippery green mass on the surface of stagnant water, yeah, on the surface of rock. So this is the feature of algae. Now according to the pigment, they are other than green. Green, most of the algae are green in color because they are having chlorophyll in them. So they are green in color. But apart from green color, they are sometimes having red color. Red algae. Most of the algae are green in color because they are having chlorophyll in them. Green pigment is chlorophyll. But sometimes apart from chlorophyll, some other pigments are present in the algae, and accordingly they are having either red color or brown color. There are, according to the pigment, there are three types of algae: green algae, red algae and brown algae. The example of green algae is Chlamydomonas, unicellular structure. These are the flagella and this is the cell, pear shaped cell it is having. This is the chlorophyll pigment, chloroplast in the algae. Red color are multicellular and branched also, filamentous body having many branches. Brown algae, like example is Polyscyphonia. Brown algae like fucus, they are having thallus like, bag like, sac like structure in the body, and they are remain on the surface of the rocks or trees. So brown algae, or sometimes ocean also they are present. These are the brown algae. Now because of all of them are having photosynthetic pigment, either it is of green color, red color or brown color, these are the photosynthetic pigment, means they can prepare their own food. That's why mode of nutrition in all the algae are autotrophs. They can prepare their own food by the process of photosynthesis. Now the way of reproduction, asexually they reproduce by budding. Again, bud is an outgrowth that form on the surface of the body. It grows in size, and when it is fully developed, it detaches itself from the body of the parent and start behaving like a new individual. Sometimes in the case of Spirogyra, you can see it is a filamentous body, and when this filament attains its maximum shape, what happened? Suppose this is the length of the normal length of the spirogyra. When it attains this much shape and size, what happens? The body automatically breaks into two or several pieces, and each piece is having an ability to give rise to a new individual. This mode of reproduction is known as fragmentation. So they can reproduce by budding, fragmentation, by the method that is known as asexual reproduction. This is all about the algae. Now in next session we will discuss about the viruses. Thank you.